Hey guys, welcome back to the channel. Today we're going to be taking a look at our exhaust leak and seeing if we can fix this exhaust leak for $8.
Start up in a little while since the last video.
Give it one more chance. Let that ECU catch up. Well, you can hear that exhaust. There we go. Always happens with these cars. You gotta give it a minute until it starts running properly. But then it runs just fine. So here's the car running. It's a bit warmed up. And you can hear that exhaust leak pretty easily. I'll show it to you in more detail in a minute. The product I'm going to be using is this quick steel thermo seal high temperature metal repair. As you can see here, exhaust, fill in holes on the exhaust, can withstand up to 2400 degrees, so this will do perfect for what I'm looking for. I was originally looking for the JB Weld Extreme Heat, but this literally has the same exact rating, so I figured I would just go with this since it was a little bit cheaper. I also went out and bought some wire brushes for cleaning the exhaust pipe and prepping it for the glue here, as well as I have some isopropyl alcohol and a paper towel that I'm gonna wipe the pipe down with once I've got all the loose rust off. All right, so let's get underneath the car and take a look at this crack we got. So right here, we got our crack right along. This is the flange for the catalytic converter. This is the front of the car this way, as you can see. So basically what I'm gonna start doing is I'm gonna wire brush around here as much as I can, remove as much loose rust as I possibly can. I'm not entirely sure how this repair might go just because of the fact that we are so close to that flange there, and the flange itself is not really looking too good either. But we're gonna see what we can do. So we can see the color starting to change from doing that brushing. It says in the instructions to leave an inch on either side, but because we don't really have an inch here, what I'm gonna try and do is get off the loose rust on this side of the flange so I can bring the adhesive all the way to this edge here, and hopefully that should do good. But I got some more cleaning to do on this pipe. Apologies for the camera angle, my tripod lasted all of about 15 seconds today, so I have to just kind of lean my phone up against one of the jack stands. But anyway, now we've got a lot of the dirt cleaned off, I'm basically just going to rub the pipe down with some rubbing alcohol. See all the dirt that's coming off of there? You want that all gone, because any dirt is going to interfere with the metal repair sticking and bonding with the metal. Look at all the dirt we got off there. And that was after hitting it with a wire brush. It's actually starting to look even maybe a little bit silver again. All right, so let's take a look at this stuff. It looks a lot more watery than I expected. Doesn't smell of anything, because of course every mechanic needs to smell stuff before they... Oh, never mind. It's actually pretty dense. I'm gonna have to mix this up a lot. I'm not sure if this little wooden stick will actually even take care of that properly because it's too thin, I think. Well, anyway, I'm gonna stir this up for a while. And once it's all stirred up, we can begin applying it to the car. So I've got this mixed up. It's definitely thickened. It seems almost like a cement mix at this point. But before we apply this to the exhaust, there's one more thing I wanna do. So at the back of the car, I have put my shop vac here, stuck it right in the tailpipe. What I'm going to do is while I apply it, I'm going to turn this on, create a little bit of negative pressure in the exhaust system, and hopefully this will get sucked up into some of the cracks, and hopefully seal a little better. And also, as it cures, you're going to want it to be warm. It's about 50 degrees out today, so I'm going to hit it with a hairdryer for a little while, and then I'm just going to give it, honestly, probably a day or two to cure entirely. And then we'll, give it a start, but I'm getting ahead of myself now. Let's actually get to putting this on the exhaust. Well, the vacuum's going. It's a bit I don't know if you'll be able to hear me talking, so if you can't hear me talking while I'm working under the car, I'll just have a song now. I'm pretty sure you guys know how this works. Just gonna be spreading it all over the place.
I can actually hear the leaks being patched as I put this stuff on, so I have faith in this product.
Well, I've spread the stuff everywhere. Everywhere I can, piled it on, pushed it into the cracks. Now all we can do is hit this with a little bit of heat and then let it cure for a day or two. I mean, the heat will just help it initially set, but... Here we are. It's been a day. Been about 24 hours. Let's start it up and see how it sounds. You know what? I gotta give it a little bit of gas. Well, she's up and running. And as you can hear, it's definitely much better. It's not perfect, but you know, I guess still there's a little bit of a noise coming from down there somewhere. But overall, I'm pretty impressed. I'll get a before and after video. There we go. Can you really hear that exhaust leak, man? Well, that's going to be it for this video, guys. I hope you enjoyed. I hope you like, subscribe, comment, and share this video with your friends and family. Any suggestions you guys want to see with this car, please comment down below. And I'll see you in my next video.